All right, so today we are going to continue with this chapter, kinetic theory. You remember we had covered it in the last week. We have covered the entire chapter. The coverage was mainly catered to the school requirements. Today we are going to see that how it is different for the competitive level preparation, okay? So you may see that there will be questions that will not only take the concepts from kinetic theory, they will be like, you know, you can't tell that this question belongs to kinetic theory or thermodynamics or thermal properties of matter. There can be a lot of questions of that nature also, which mix all the chapters together and come as a problem to you. Fine. So we'll see a couple of those kind of questions also. But before I start giving you questions my own, let me check, like, have you guys done the assignment? Did you find it difficult, easy, moderate? How it was? It was easy. Okay, so you have any doubts? Do you have any doubts from it? One doubt, what is that? Question number 14. Oh, everyone has that doubt. All right, is there any other question other than 14? Anyone? Question number 14. Does this have 14? This one? Okay. Yes, I remember. It was there on the group. Nobody replied to Anusha on the group. You can do that. Probably nobody was sure about the answer. That's why. All right. So let us see how to do this. If a piston is moved in so as to reduce the volume of a gas by half, keeping the temperature of gas constant. So basically what is happening is that there is something like that. Okay, this is closed from here. Then this piston, which was here earlier, has been brought to there. Okay, so if the volume is halved, keeping temperature constant, pressure will be doubled. So temperature is the same temperature, so isothermal. If it is isothermal, what I can tell about the velocity of the gas, velocity or the speed of the gas molecules will be? Speed won't change, right? Because the kinetic energy is 3/2 kT. Kinetic energy depends on temperature. Okay. Since kinetic energy depends on the temperature, if temperature is same, kinetic energy will be same, and hence the speed will be same. So speed will not change. Okay. So why the pressure is doubled on the vertical wall over there? That is what we need to answer. All right. So momentum change per collision is doubled while frequency of collision remains constant. Momentum change per collision. Momentum change per collision won't be different because the velocity is same. So with whatever velocity it hits the wall, with same velocity, it will bounce back, right? So A is definitely wrong. B will also be wrong because momentum change per collision. Oh, sorry. Momentum change per collision, they say it is constant. Momentum change per collision, both are increased. So A and C both are wrong. All of you understand that? Now, what about frequency of the collision? Is that doubled? Is that doubled? On the vertical walls, on the vertical side walls. Number of molecules per unit volume, it will increase or not? N by V, it will be doubled. Same number of molecules will be in a lesser number of volume, lesser amount of volume. So number of molecules per unit volume will increase. So you know pressure, you have derived it 1/3 N M to V square. You remember this, all of you? Okay, so basically N is increasing, but here none of the options talks about number of molecules per unit volume changing. Okay, so we need to see force. What is force? Do you remember that expression for force? Force divided by area, we have taken volume, right? Force is 1/3 N M V square into area. This is what it is, right? Now, over here, there is this is number of molecules per unit volume. So force is equal to, see, we cannot have two variables. A is also changing, right? On the side walls, whatever the area has become half. All of you understand that? So it'll be 1/3 number of molecule N divided by the overall volume to M into V square to area. Okay. So N, M and V square, they are fixed. Area divided by volume is changing, right? Area divided by volume has become what? Area divided by volume has become half. No, half. How it is doubled? Yeah, sorry, V is V by 2. Yeah, correct. V is V by 2 and area. Number of molecules is same, M V square. Area of cross section over here. This area, no, we have to take the side area. Side area also, side area becomes half, right? A by 2. Side areas become A by 2. So the volume, pressure can't remain same, right? Because volume has become half. Some trick we are missing here. This is N is total number of molecules divided by the new volume. It is the new volume is V by 2. Area is A by 2. So force will remain same. Okay, so we can see here the force, all of you, force remains same. All of you understand force remains same? Type in on the side walls, the force will remain same. Now, pressure is what? Pressure is force divided by area. area is A by 2. Okay, so pressure will become double or not? Pressure is becoming double because area is becoming half, not because of any other reason. So that's why option D. Clear to everyone? All right. Now let's take up few questions that are not so direct. Let me put it. Whatever doubt there is, you have to directly write down the doubt. Don't say that I have a doubt. Then I'll ask you, okay, tell me the doubt. What causes frequency of collision to increase? The velocity increase. When velocity increases, then only number of collisions. You have to see the derivation, how it is derived. Okay. Look at the derivation. Things will be clear. What are the derivation? M into V is the incoming momentum. So total change in momentum is 2mv. We had to multiply with the rate at which it is colliding. How you get rate at which it is colliding? N dn by dt, right? How you get rate at which it is colliding? You have to find out number of molecules in a volume of A into V into delta T n. So delta n by delta T, we have done this derivation. This is equal to A V into n. This is the collision frequency, A V into n. Fine. See, A is becoming half, number of molecules per volume is all is becoming double. So A is half and N is double. So delta N by delta T remains same. It doesn't change. Okay. You can't solve it theoretically. Okay. It is not history we are studying. We are studying physics. You need to solve it like that. Okay. Then only answer it. All right. Answer these questions now. Focus here. Oro was not even listening what I was saying. He was busy solving these questions. Huh? Okay, everyone. Which of the following parameter is same for the molecules of all gases at a given temperature? All gases. Can I say speed? No, because masses can be different. Kinetic energy doesn't depend on the mass of a molecule. It is simply this. It is the kinetic energy, not the speed. Okay. This kinetic energy will be equal to half mass of the molecule into V square. Mass of the molecule can depend on which gas we are talking about. Okay. Next one. A gas behaves more closely than ideal gas at low pressure and high temperature. Okay. Very nice. So, good start. This one. Energy of a given sample of ideal gas depends only on its. Okay. Simple. Temperature. Which of the following gas has maximum RMS speed at a given temperature? which one will have whichever has the lesser mass of molecule? Which one has it? Hydrogen. Okay. Kinetic energy is same, but that is equal to half mv square. So that's why. Okay, these are very simple questions. Don't worry, we'll increase this. Take it here. Some of it you can answer by using chemistry concepts also. States of matter is done, right, in chemistry? So you can use those concepts also. All right. First one, for an now it is about P and rho. Do you know this equation? P is equal to rho RT by N. Do you know this? Right? So for an ideal gas, this is the situation. And if for the same density, if I get two different temperature, if density is same, pressure is proportional to temperature. So T1 is more than T2. So clearly option A. Why it is D? All of you understand? First one. T1 is greater than T2. How this comes? By P into V is mass of the gas divided by molecular mass into RT. So P is equal to M by V, RT by M. So M by V is density. So rho RT by M. So you need to modify the equation in terms of what you want. Okay, P and rho only. Fine, this one, root mean square at absolute temperature is proportional to under root T. No, it is a mean square speed. It's not RMS speed. It is not root. It is not root mean. It is just a square, mean square. Mean square it is. So root mean square is proportional to root T. Mean square is proportional to square of that. Okay. I hope things are clear. I'll put next question here itself. First one, the pressure of a gas kept in a isothermal container is 200 kilopascal. If half the gas is removed, the pressure will be what? I mean, naturally you'll tend to think that it is half only, because PV is equal to nRT. It's an isothermal container, temperature is constant, it's a container, volume is constant, number of mole will become half. So when n is equal to n by 2, P2 will be equal to P1 by 2. Okay, so it will be half. So 100 kilopascal. This one, next. The RMS speed of oxygen molecule in a gas is V. If the temperature is doubled, Okay, all of you, should I launch a poll for this? Should I launch a poll for this? Take this poll. For the second one, okay, so this is what you guys have selected. Let us see. So we have a temperature doubled and we need to find out the RMS speed. So the kinetic energy will become two times the earlier kinetic energy. 2k it will be, right? So 2k will be equal to half of m into v square, right? Earlier kinetic energy k was equal to half. For molecule, it was 2m into V naught square. Do you all understand these two equations? Earlier kinetic energy was K. Now because temperature has doubled, it will become 2K. All right. Now when you divide these two equations, you'll get 2 is equal to V square by 2 V naught square. So from here, V is equal to 2 times of V naught. So velocity will be 2V. Correct, majority of you. All right, so objective questions are over now. Do these. What I'll do, I'll go to the next slide, put it over here. Okay. Equal masses of air are sealed in two vessels, one of volume V naught and the other is 2 V naught. First vessel is maintained at 300 Kelvin, other at 600. The ratio of pressure in the two vessels. So, equal masses of the air, it means number of moles are same. Okay. So we have PV is equal to, I think it's a direct application of ideal gas equation. So P1 into V naught is equal to NRT naught, and then P2 into 2 V naught is equal to number of moles same, R into temperature is 2T naught. So clearly P1 is equal to P2. Okay. So P1 is equal to P2. So these are simple questions. Okay, this I'll skip. To this one. Diathermic means what, everyone? What do you understand by diathermic? It's a highly conducting thing. It makes sure that there is no difference of temperature between the two sides of this separator. Okay, it basically ensures temperature remains same on the both sides. That's all. Auro got it. Others. It's a simple question. Three is to one, everyone. It slides here so that this portion of the volume, this is V naught by 3. No, sorry, this is V naught by 4, and this volume will be 3 V naught by 4. You might have got this. The ratio of the volumes are this, right? temperature on both sides are equal, T and T, because our diathermic wall temperatures are equal. Number of moles, they are equal or not, both sides? Number of moles are equal, right? So P into 3 V naught by 4 is equal to nRT, and P2 into V naught by 4 is equal to nRT. So from here, you'll get P2 to be equal to 3 times of P1. Okay. I think straightforward. Anyone has any doubt, quickly type in. We'll go to the next question. I have to quickly find something difficult. Enough of these direct ones. Let's do this first. Condition for equilibrium is what? Condition for equilibrium, everyone? Pressure and temperature should be same throughout. Shitish got it. Others? Okay, Pradyun Oro also got. Anyone else? Arabi, Aditi. So we have PA into V. PV is equal to number of moles. Number of moles are not given. Let's say NA to R into TA. Okay. So we have over here NA is equal to PA into V divided by R into TA. Similarly, NB is equal to PB V divided by R into TB. Okay. And at the end, when they mix and attain equilibrium, total pressure is, let's say, P, the volume will be 2V. Now gas can spread in 2V volume and number of moles will be NA plus NB R into T, this one. So you can substitute the value of NA plus NB over there. P into 2V is equal to PA divided by RTA plus PB divided by RTB into RT into V. So V will get cancelled away. R is also gone. So you have this relation. Straightforward like this. Do this. Yes, temperature in terms of P naught, V naught. The final answer for this, let me see. Yes, P naught, V naught. In terms of that, you should get. Okay. P naught V naught by 2R. Many are getting that answer. Temperature we have to find out when V is equal to V naught. So we should get a relation between V and T. So I have to write pressure equals to NRT by V. Fine. It is 1 mole, so N is 1. Okay. So RT by V is equal to P naught divided by 1 plus V by V naught whole square. So just put V is equal to V naught. You will have RT by V naught is equal to P naught by V is equal to V naught, so P naught by 2. Temperature will be equal to P naught V naught by 2R. Okay, fine. Now I'll give you a question myself. Suppose you have a situation in which there is a heater at t equal to 0, the spring in its natural length, okay, the initial pressure is P naught, initial volume is V naught. Okay, the heater supplies heat of delta Q. All right, assume that the spring get compressed. Spring get compressed by an amount of X. Okay, it's a slow process. Spring get compressed by X. When you supply heat delta Q, you need to find out the final temperature of gas. Initial temperature is also given. Initial temperature is T naught. Okay. And area of the piston, if you want, is given as A. Okay. Find out. All walls are insulated. Do this. Meanwhile, I'll find out some other questions. No one? Anyone close to the answer? Okay, I'm waiting. The hint is you may have to use first law of thermodynamics. All right, we'll do it now. Everyone, focus here. So, we have first law of thermodynamics, delta Q is equal to delta U plus the work done, W. Fine. So, delta Q is given to us. Delta Q is given to us. Delta U is how much? Delta U is N CV delta T. What is W? How much is W? Everyone. W is integral of F dx, right? The gas is pushing this, right? And it is a slow process. So the gas force should be equal to kx only. Whatever the spring force is, same force the gas should also apply. So slowly it is pushing it. Okay. So integral f dx is kx dx integral only. Whatever work gas does, it is stored in the spring as its potential energy only. So delta Q is equal to n Cv delta T plus half kx square. Okay. Now it is straightforward. You will get the value of delta T. Delta T is equal to delta Q minus half kx square divided by n Cv, right? Where n is equal to P naught V naught by R T naught. This is N, which you can substitute here. Okay, CV should be given to you, of course. If I tell you it is monoatomic, what is the value of CV? If I write it is monoatomic, CV is equal to what? All of you. 5/3. No, no. 5/3 is gamma. CV is 3R/2. CP is 5R/3. Gamma is Cp by Cv. All right. So this is the way you do this question. What do you mean PdV work done? PdV work done is derived from FdX only. Okay. Pressure on this wall is what? Pressure on the pressure is P. So force is P into A. Into dx. Okay. So P into A becomes your force, which is kx. Okay. Okay, one more question. Probably, I think we are finishing up the problems quickly. So after a couple of questions, we'll start some other chapter. Meanwhile, write down this question. You have a tube. You have a horizontal tube like this. Okay. Tube of length L. There's a tube of length L, which is closed at both the ends. It contains ideal gas whose molecular weight is M. Molecular mass, molar mass is M. It is rotated by angular velocity omega about the axis passing through this point. Axis passes through that point, and this entire rod is rotated like that with angular velocity omega. Okay. Assume that temperature is constant and uniform. You have to find out, you have to get the pressure. Okay. Just a second. Assume P1, P2, P1 denotes the pressure at the free end and the fixed end. Okay, so you need to find out relation between this pressure, let's call it as P1, and pressure over here, P2. Between pressure over here and pressure over there, what is the relation you have to find out? Okay, all of you understood the question? Do this. I'll write down. Clear? Do it now. Anyone close to the answer? Should I wait? Okay. Should I give hint? Okay, here is a hint. You have to use mechanics also here, okay? Mechanics won't leave you. Take a small element at a distance of x, okay? The hint is draw the free body diagram of this. This small mass that you have taken at a distance of x, draw the free body diagram of this mass. Okay, now try it. Clear to everyone? Should I discuss? Anyone close to getting answer? Auro, understood? Got the answer? Are you understood but didn't get the answer? How come? Okay. I'll discuss it now. So listen here, this is the small dm mass that you have taken. This is dm. Okay. So this dm mass will experience pressure from this part of the gas and pressure from that part of the gas. Which pressure will be higher? What do you think? Right or left? Right or left, everyone? P1 is higher or P2 is higher? That's a guess, right? Whatever you're telling me is a guess. Whatever you're told is a guess. Now tell me logically which one should be correct, P1 or P2? Logic. What logic you'll apply? What logic you'll apply? Shitish, you can't answer both sides. Are you getting it? Only two options are correct. First you answer left and now you're telling right. So which logic will you apply? Which logic? No one? Newton's second law. Newton's second law you have to apply. Which direction is the acceleration? Which direction is the acceleration? No, forget about compression and all. Which direction is acceleration for this dm? Is this acceleration or not for this dm? Which direction it is? On the left direction, centripetal acceleration? All of you? What is the acceleration? Omega square x. Okay. So net, this side should be the acceleration. So which pressure should be higher now? Right hand side pressure should be higher, isn't it? Do you all understand this now? P1 plus, you can say DP. Everyone is understood. Now apply Newton's second law. How you'll apply Newton's second law? P1 plus DP minus P1 is equal to dm omega square x. Okay. So dp is equal to dm omega square x. Now what to do, everyone? Now what to do? Everyone, now what to do? How many variables there are? Pressure, mass, and x. Can you solve this? Oh, sorry, you need to multiply by area here, this into area. Area into pressure is force. So that's why. So dp is equal to dm omega square x by a. Yeah. Clear, Anusha? Integrate. How will you integrate? How will you integrate? There are three variables. P, M, and X. How will you integrate? You have to use ideal gas equation here. So P is equal to rho RT by M. You remember this? Rho RT by M. So I will get density is equal to MP by RT. I have written density in terms of pressure so that I can find out DM, which is rho into the volume of this, which is how much? If this is dx, the volume is adx. So dm is rho into adx. So that is mp by rt to adx. Okay, clear? Till now it is clear to everyone. This is equation number one. This is equation number two. Whenever gas is there, you have to use ideal gas equation somewhere. Okay. All right. So we have, I will write both of these. Other one. So if I write dm like this, mp by rt into adx omega square x by a, then a and a will get cancelled away. And you can see here that the variables are only p and x. Do you all see that? I can write it as dp by p is equal to m omega square by rt into x dx. Okay. So I can integrate this from 0 to L, and the pressure will go from P1 to P2. dp by p integral is what? Everyone. What is dp by p integral? Ln p, log p. So log of p2 minus log of p1 is equal to m omega square l square by 2rt. So I'll get ln of p2 by p1 is equal to m omega square L square by 2RT. So you will get P2 by P1 is equal to e to the power M omega square L square by 2RT. Okay, so P2 is equal to P1 e to the power M omega square L square by 2 times RT. Let me check the answer. Yes, this is what it is. All of you understood? Everyone understood? Type in. There is no such formula, Kshitij. No. You're saying P1 is equal to P2 plus rho GH. You want to use that? But then here things are accelerating. It is not. No. Don't create theorems. Are you getting it? Do not create theorems your own. P1, that equation which you're telling me, Pascal's equation, variation of pressure with height, right? That is true only when the fluid is at rest, okay? Or at least there is a constant acceleration. Here, even acceleration is not constant throughout. Omega square x, where x keeps on varying. So do not get into adventurous thing. Put your imagination in solving numericals. Don't on the spot come up with certain theory, okay? For that, years of research is required. Then only something you can say that we can use something like that. Clear, right, everyone? Let us now, what Kshitij was saying, let us take something like that. So you can use that thing which, Kshitij, you get this one right then. Here you can use it, whatever you're saying. Suppose you have a container, okay? You have a container of height h, area of cross section is a uniform cylinder is there, okay? The pressure on the top of the cylinder is atmospheric pressure p naught. P naught is a pressure. You need to tell me total mass of the gas inside. Total mass of the gas inside. Assume that temperature is fixed, T naught. Okay, do that. And it may not be very obvious. You need to assume variation of pressure with height. This is only for Kshitij because he asked something like that. No, I mean, everyone can solve it. No, Aro, that's not correct. P, what is P? P is not given to you. Should I give hint? Hint is you can't solve it just like that. Little bit of integral is there. Another hint is take P is equal to P naught plus rho g h. Okay. Should I discuss? DM is density over there into A into DX. Density into volume is DM. Okay. So if you can integrate this, you'll get total mass. But the problem is area is constant, but density is not constant. So can you get density as a function of X? Can you do that? This is density in terms of pressure. Okay. Rho is equal to MP by RT. But do we know pressure as a function of Y? Can I find out pressure as a function of Y? What I can write? Pressure as a function of Y, what I can write? Tell me. All of you, can you tell me, can I write this like that? P is equal to P naught plus rho g y. Can I write like that? Is this correct? Is this expression correct? All of you type in. This is not correct. Density is not constant. Very good. Density is not constant. So how can you take like that? Right? But in a differential form, is this equation correct? That dp is equal to rho g dy. Is this correct? Right? This is correct. Like here I should write y. This is y dy dy. So dp is equal to rho g dy. So I will write dp is equal to, now can you solve it? Like it's interesting now. I've written all the possible equations. It's just solution now. Mathematics is left. No one is getting it. No one. Okay, what you do is that using this equation, first and second equation, get pressure as a function of y. Can you get that? So dp is equal to rho that is mp by rt into g dy, right? So dp by p is equal to m g by rt dy. So 0 to y, and pressure will go from p naught to p. Are you able to understand what I'm doing here? Any guesses why I'm finding p as a function of y? Everyone, why I'm finding pressure as a function of y? How does that help me? So this will give me p is equal to p naught e to the power m g y by r t. I have got pressure as a function of y. No, I want mass, right? I want this. So using this, I can get the density as a function of y, which I can later on substitute in this equation. Which one? In this equation, later on I can substitute. I can get the density as a function of y by using equation 2 and this equation 3. All right. So density will be equal to m rho, which is this entire thing, m p naught by rt e to the power m g y by rt. So we have finally got density as a function of y, which I will substitute over here and integrate from 0 to h to get the total mass inside the container. Everyone understood this? Type in. Is it clear to everyone? Clear? Okay. This is how it will be in J Advanced. Okay, this is how it will be. Fine. So I guess the problem practice for the kinetic theory of gases, I was wondering whether you have a lot of doubts. So I thought entire class will go in that. But then good that all the doubts are cleared. Do you have any other doubt from any other assignment? We can discuss that also today. Any other assignment you want to discuss? Anything? What about RBD? RBD assignments are all fine. No doubts. No one has any doubts from RBD. Okay, good. If you want, I can discuss RBD assignments. You don't want any discussion of that sorts? My question is, Pradyun, have you attempted it? If you have attempted, you should have doubts about the questions, that this is a question. You will not say discuss entire DPP. Okay, that is not doubt. Which question? So if I scroll down, will you be able to identify your doubts? Let me do that. So only Pradyun has doubts. Everybody else is very sure about entire rigid body dynamics. So probably we don't need a separate problem solving on rigid body.